I have to pause for a second. I forgot to plug in one of my laptops. Holy shit. Right as Scott comes in. Motherfuck. Well, this will be good.
Roll that again.
Who's Scott?
Well, we'll find out. I can do this.
Wow.
I completely have to put you on pause.
No, Adam, we don't need you. We're talking to Scott. We're fine.
Okay, cool. Cool.
Yeah.
Adam, hi, no one needs you.
I know. Can we fix this in post?
Saved. Holy fuck. I'm sorry about that.
Where are you, Adam?
Have a week, kids.
He's in the garage.
Oh, man.
Like Weezer.
Okay. We'll pretend that didn't happen. Someone just forgot to plug in one of the two laptops. No big deal. Who does someone tech? Not me. All right. Are you ready?
Are you finishing your take?
You're the one that freaked out, Adam. So yes,
I know,
we're ready.
I'm sorry.
Finish your take on Follow Me, and then we'll turn it over to introducing Scott.
Okay.
You were all done, right?
Yes. Well, I mean, I was just getting started. So I'll just say this. The jangle is just so great. How great? Oh, I don't know. Johnny Marr got up and played it with him once, and that's pretty good. Which takes us to a quick, what is it called? Made up fact, which is that even Jimmy Fallon named his autobiography, Fallon Me, after this. And you can't dispute those kinds of things. And with bad jokes, I couldn't think of a better person to suddenly crash our Zoom than my good friend Scott Kennerly, because he's 10 times funnier than me so many ways, shapes, and forms.
Oh, man. His eyes rolled hard during your Fell on Me joke. So
yeah, you got me on cold medicine too. So you're getting all.
Oh, this is going to be good.
Yeah, you're getting somebody. I'm unhinged.
The nasal thing is so on point though for like early REM, you know. So I think
I'll mumble
you're good.
A lot. I'll try.
Yeah, exactly. I've known Scott for, oh my gosh, many years. We met because both of our bands played together, and one of the things that we bonded on was this band. Some of our listeners might know him more from his earlier works. He started a little ska band called Bucko 9 many, many years ago.
Hugely then, influenced by REM, as you can
see. Exactly. Exactly.
I can hear it. Yeah, now that you mention it, I can hear it. I totally
it's,
hear
it's
it.
It's all of those early two-tone records that REM did. But he wanted to make a side project where he could get in his counter melodies. And so he started this band called Plural that I adore.
Yeah, we tried to do all that. Unsuccessfully.
I don't know about that. You sure got compared to them a lot and right and on par in so many ways. I assume that you love this album a lot from what you told me earlier about it.
Well, it's kind of interesting. You know, you threw this album out and we were talking about it. This is the album that I bought that got me into REM in 86, 87, right?
So 86, yeah.
I got the album. And, you know, REM was kind of this mystery thing, right? You didn't know what it was. I didn't know anything about it. And I got this album and it's perfect. It's like a perfect record. So I don't know where you guys are at on this. I'm just crashing here. I'm just going to say it's a perfect record.
The two smarter gentlemen on this call agree with you completely.
So you're what you're saying is the guy who chose this album for the pod would be a genius.
I'm just saying if you want to talk about I don't even know if this is about, if you're talking about perfect records and you, that one's perfect. That one's perfect. This is probably perfect to me. I went through, you know, I listened to this a bunch recently and I was like, oh, this song's great. This song's great. This song's great. This, I was just like, this is, it's perfect. It's got the vibe of the era of that 86 era. So I don't know what you guys are age and all that stuff, but at this time, right, I had got, you know, I had Life Search Pageant, and then what's on like my rotation list, right, would be like Life Search Pageant, and then Queen is Dead came out, I think, right around 86 or so. So I mean, these are big records, you know. These are like, and I'm 14, 15, 16. I can't remember how old I was.
You're on the right call, dude.
Could your brain comprehend?
These are your people. These are your people.
Yeah, this was like, you know, I left the world of, listening to my 50s music, my pop 50s music, right? I was like a kid. And it was like, you know, music was never interesting to me, the pop radio. And then this was coming out, and those albums are like, what are they singing about? Like, mm-hmm. you know, like the Smiths right. record, which you guys should probably do one too, because that's
already
like,
did. Good.
Already Done did. Good. Episode Done two.
Oh, we did? Oh, okay, yeah, we did it.
That record's great.
Who chose right. that record to do?
Right. Yeah, this record. I mean, you think 86? 86 is just this monster year. Yep. But this record, I think, is perfect. I mean, the album cover's perfect. It's like the artwork is perfect on it. Yep. The track listing and how it kind of takes you through everything. I was like, is there a better starting track? And I was like, oh, no, obviously Begin to Begin, right? It's a great name for the start.
Right.
And I was like, could you start with I Believe? I was like, oh, you probably could have started and tripped people out with that banjo, right? The, but I was like, no, I mean, the album's perfect. Like, the sequencing's great on it. And the sound, it has that 80s vibe sound. And I just love the production on it, too. It's I've always been stoked on that record.
Well, we didn't want to get too much into it because, like, we always say save it for the pod. So I wanted to get your opinion on it. But the one thing you did tell me we talked about just before was that Jim here, who picked the record, had a Cuyahoga era REM poster. Is that the same one that you had where it listed the words from Cuyahoga? Or you said you still had your Life's Rich Pageant poster from all those years ago?
Yeah, so I still have all my posters. I have my green I have a giant green right. poster right. like I have all the green, like, you know, green 88 that concert was March 16th at the Sports Arena here.
Wow, look at you.
That was my first concert.
Hey, buddy, oh, nice. We were there, and I don't know about you, but the next day is St. Patrick's Day, and I wore my green concert T-shirt, like green on St. Patty's, and everybody was like, lame.
Still funny. Still funny, Jim.
That was a great show.
That's yeah, I that was my first concert. I bought, you know, I went to go get a, you know, concert T-shirt for $60. I don't know how it was.
Outrageous. Yeah. Felt like
still outrageous now. All they had were like double extra large. I bought it anyways. I had to buy it. I still have it. Nice. I still have the concert T-shirt. Like that was, you know, this band is this weird seminal moment of my life for multiple years. Like going to the day their album released, the whole deal. So REM is a big one for, REM is a big one. and this album, it, you know, was the gateway to it. And right after this, I got Dead Letter Office, because that had come out, and I was like, oh, okay, what is this, right? And I you know, I wasn't smart enough to know it was a bunch of B-sides or something like that. I just thought it was this trippy record. Mm-hmm. And then immediately it was like, I think it was just a couple months later, document comes out.
Uh-huh. Right.
And it was like, I mean, these three kind of, mm-hmm. and Document's amazing too. I mean, Document's great. They're great, mm-hmm. as well, but this one's perfect.
Well, mm-hmm. if you think it's perfect, then I'm even more curious for you to tell us what your favorite song on the record is, because that's what we're here for today. So let's have it.
Okay.
If you had to choose one.
There can only be one winner.
If it makes you feel any better, the last guy still chose his top four.
Well,
it's that hard.
You know, like, if you said, like, hey, what do I gravitate to? Like if I popped on the record and I saw that track listing and I go, oh, what do I really want to hear? Oddly, I want to hear Swan H, right?
Wow. Nice.
Like, that's like the one I want to vibe into. Mm-hmm. But then... Mm-hmm. When I Believe comes on, I think it's the perfect REM song. Like, to me, it's got everything you've ever wanted in an REM song. And it's like the espresso shot of REM, right?
Yes.
It's just condensed and delicious. And, you know, it leaves you.
That's awesome.
Because there's a great spot, too. There's a, like, that I guess it's almost like the, because it's really rocking. But when it breaks down in the verse, right, that, when I was young and full, like that whole part there, right? I can't sing it because the copyright infringement. We all know how that works.
It's literally playing underneath you in post.
I would go there. That is like, it's got so much like textural sort of stuff and the whole vibe of it. And then that's that kind of thing that leaves you right after the song's over. You're like, oh, I want to go back and hear that one part again. Like, wow, that really that part's really cool. And then I do have to say, like, I mean, I listened to, I think Fall on Me is still like the first like mature, like what they're capable of. Mm-hmm. It's like this glimpse into their, into mm-hmm. like, we can put together this full package that's
grand,
bigger than us, bigger than whatever. It's not a genre. It's not a thing we're doing. It's like, I believe is like, to me is like really like, hey, we're, this is who we are as a rock and roll band, but mm-hmm. Fall on Me is like, this is who we are as like artists. It might be their first sort of like
nice
real blend of like us as artists that can craft something, that crafted something.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And, but I still like, I love the vibe of Swan, Swan, the Hummingbird. I just like when that whole vibe comes in,
oh,
that's,
there's the poster.
That's the one. That's my poster.
Is that the poster you had? Jim just put up his 100%.
That's that is,
yeah, yeah, that's
you're,
my,
you're
that's
in my childhood
too.
Bedroom. Right next to that, that is The Cure.
That oh, same with him.
It's The Cure.
Wait, which Cure poster? We have to ask, because he had a huge Boys Don't Cry poster. So yeah.
No, no, this wasn't Boys Don't Cry. This was actually...
I had five of them. There was just five heads, and Robert's lipstick was all messed up. And anyway.
Mine was like a real colorful one, and his lipstick was probably messed up.
Yeah,
and his hair, you know, amazingly messed up, and but yeah, that was next to that was a kind of a newer poster of The Cure. It was kind of a middle later era. I wouldn't even know what to say what it was.
Yeah. Okay.
All right, man.
It's awesome, and you're completely correct in every opinion you've said so far.
Well, thanks for taking time out of your busy dad schedule closing
has
thoughts.
Has anybody chose their songs yet? Has there anybody chosen their
Yeah,
we're up to number one. So we've been listing all of our songs, and we're up to number one right now as a collective.
We haven't listed our number one songs yet, or the song that we all averaged out to number one. We're just finished number two.
You want to stay on and see
if you want to stick around for a big reveal, because we don't know what our number one song is collectively. We're right about to say it. So if you want to stay, just agree or disagree, you're more than welcome.
I want to listen.
All right, we're going to stop recording. Scott, thank you so
much.
Sorry, stop recording.
I didn't mean to hijack that ending there.
No, you fit. You fit,
yes,
you fit really well. You fit really well, dude.
We're off to the races on it.
All right, I don't know if I recorded it correctly for you, Adam.
Okay, well, if not, we have a backup that I can fly in, because you didn't, like, you spaced out where you were talking good, so I should be able to work with it either way. Send me what you got when you get a chance.
Well, what's going on is I'm recording this right now. I'm watching the meter go up, and it's going up when you talk too. And I'm like, I don't know how I patched that, because I only patched this mic. So.
Huh. Okay.
I don't know what's going on.
Well, we'll see. It still might sound better. It'll probably sound better for your voice though, probably. So send me what you got.
Okay.
And I'll cut it up.
All right, guys. That was fun, man.
Dude, thanks for so much.
Thanks for hanging.
Do you guys do it on video?
No one wants to see
it. It's just an audio.
I record them, but we don't release
it. We would. Adam has a radio face, so
yeah, totally.
Yeah, he's got that moonlighting blur on mine. It looks good.
You like that?
Yeah, exactly. Woo! Some walk by night. All right.
You doing good, Scott? I haven't talked to you in forever.
Yeah, except for this cold that I got this morning. So
perfect timing.
It's good.
I'm coming down with something too.
Awesome. Oh, yeah, I'm gonna be living there part time, like starting in a week or so. So I really want to see you and the kids.
In San Diego?
Yeah.
I'm in North County now, by the way.
I know. But I have to drive through North County to get there.
Where are you guys all at?
He's in Colorado. I'm in Woodland Hills now, in the Valley. You guys?
I'm in Oakland.
I'm in Oxnard, California. You know where that is?
Near Santa Barbara.
Half hour south of Santa Barbara.
Ventura County, something like that.
Ventura County.
Which high school did you go to, Scott?
I went to Mount McGill.
Okay.
In Spring Valley.
Dan and Jim and I all went to University City. And Scott, I know from San Diego State.
Ah, oh wow, long ways back. Nice.
My daughter's at State right now, living it up.
How do you know him from State?
No, I know you from State. Scott, I know. How do we know each other? Through our friend.
Oh, you said that wrong.
Scott, yeah, totally. I was like, Man, I never went to Saints.
I didn't see where I was pointing.
Okay, so that's you, Adam. Oh.
Scott and I have a mutual friend named Day Solani, who was a San Diego State guy, and he said, "Oh, you have to meet my friends, John and Scott, who had just started Plural, and he brought you to see us when they showed the Wilco documentary. We played an opening set before the movie." And we were instantly like, blah, blah, music.
Yeah, yeah. What ages are you guys?
50.
51.
I just turned 50 or 49 last week, I think.
Just a pup.
My childhood number one, nobody asked. My childhood number one was Swan H and Flowers of Guatemala. They would switch off every week.
That's funny, Jim. I didn't get to talk about them.
Oh yeah, there's a bunch. What did you guys really want to say that we didn't get to?
Oh, a bunch of stuff.
Yeah, we'll save it. I sort of appreciate.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, I like that. I mean, I've been pushing for top five and least song to cut down on the length, and of course that's the week that I somehow managed to get two guests, not just one.
Totally cut down.
But Jim,
when you said that your childhood one was Swan H or whatever, like going back and forth, that was immediately what, like, when I opened it up, I was like, that's all I ever wanted to listen to. I just listened to that song on repeat.
And you learned
now I'm older, maybe I'm not, it wouldn't be, but it was just like, that's like my sentimental favorite.
Absolutely.
I don't know why.
Six of on one hand, half a dozen the other.
I'm
kind of glad that for this record we didn't end up doing a lot of those mid ones, because I would have felt like a Debbie Downer for once. I couldn't really get into so many or have an opinion on a lot of these songs. I'm sorry. Like, I love my top four. I fucking love them. So like when you guys are, it's a perfect album, I'm like, I guess I disagree for once. Like,
I think Hyena would have been better or higher if the chorus was better.
100%. That's so
true. Because the verse, Peter Buck's doing. And, you know, Hyena is right after Cuyahoga.
Right.
Well, if we're going to talk about the one thing you got to give Hyena is after he screams Hyena a bunch of times, it always ends with, which is so great.
Now, I did want to mention this. If you go on Spotify and you look at the listens, right? What's the least listened to song? Probably Underneath the Bunker, but
avoid that. Yeah.
No, but I'm just interesting, you know, when you look at like, okay, where people fall off and like,
yeah, totally.
Record fall off. I think it's Just a Touch. I did rank these just for.
Yeah, you're right.
Well, let's hear your ranking from bottom.
Bottom is just a Touch.
Correct.
That was my least.
Underneath the Bunker.
Correct.
What If We Give It Away?
Correct.
And then I have These Days and Begin Deep, because also it's like, as the album progresses, so I start enjoying the other stuff more and more. And so I was putting this together and it was like there's this whole middle ground group that you're like, mm-hmm. I don't know what I like more. Like, I like them all, mm-hmm. but I can't pick it out. So I had These Days, then Begin. Superman, I throw in there, and now it's like, I don't even need it. Like, I don't.
Yeah,
like,
I know.
I was so curious about where you would put Superman, because, and I mentioned it in the beginning. I didn't even mention it when you came on. Was that you guys covered it?
Yeah.
I always thought, why would you cover that song? It's a cover of a cover, and you guys are so great. You did some other covers that were fucking fantastic, but that one was always like, you do it good, but it's like, not my favorite.
I think we liked it because of the thing you guys were talking about with Mike Mills and the counter harmonies.
It's just
all counter harmonies. And our version of it, and I think
we added more.
We added more, right? And because I think, you know, when you listen to the original version of it, it's even more than they're doing in a lot of spots. I mean, it's a cool cover. It's a great cover at that time, right? Like, that's like that golden gem. It's like,
A great song. It's such a fun, enjoyable song. Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, We all learned it. We all learned
It's so easy to do. If I remember right, I was so flattered that you asked me to come in and sing on it. I'm like, you don't need me. You guys are such great singers. And then the version that you recorded, you scrapped, if I remember right. Like, you were to record at some guy's studio, and then, like, there was a falling out, and you couldn't use it, and so you just re-recorded it.
Who knows? Yeah, I don't know. That was like,
because I'm not on it.
but that I do like when you, that album. I mean, this I was totally sincere. Like when I look at this record and I see these songs, I'm just like, I don't know how many times I listen to that cassette of this album, just back and forth, back and forth. I just listen to it so much.
Totally.
His band didn't do a ton of covers, but I put together an all Cure covers day. I think it was one of the cancer benefits, and I put them on in the middle, and they totally stole the show. Doing, I think it was all stuff off the first record, if I remember. I can totally remember you because you recorded Jumping Someone Else's Train. But
yeah,
I think
we did
Fire in Cairo,
and just Boys no one was Cry doing it, because it was like you'd send out a list and everybody like grabbed the songs. I was like, no one's grabbed Boys Don't Cry. It's like, yeah, I'll take that. And then it was like Fire in Cairo. It would be like, oh, I always love that kind of oddball thing.
Yeah.
So we grabbed that, and then our cover of our was really good. The Jeff, our drummer, doing he was great doing that song. So
for which Jumping Someone Else's Train?
Yeah, that was that whole at the end.
Yeah, totally.
He was so just awesome.
Right. And forever when I hear that song, there's a harmony that you guys did that's super unique and cool. And he's like, you know where I got that from? I was like, where? Oh, it's the harmony from Caught by the Fuzz by Supergrass. And
oh,
like,
yeah.
I can't love you anymore.
yeah. If you ever, it takes you 5 minutes, every song is stolen from something.
I'll be sending them a link to Plural stuff, because they'll totally dig it. It's so good.
Nice.
Not to be forgotten.
It's fine.
I can't wait. Peter, Elvis Costello is the biggest Liverpool Football Club fan in the world.
That's right. That's right. All right.
So
well, this
could be fun.
Save all your opinions, because I really don't know any of your thoughts about Elvis. I know Scott's very well now, but not the rest of you guys, so I can't wait.
Of a different record. Yeah.
Of a different record, that's right.
Almost blue. almost blue.
I love
it. All right, bye guys.
All right. It was great to talk to you, Scott, and
thanks,
all the rest
everybody.
Of you.
It was fun.